Bornovas Michael. I'm a dentist and the president of the Association of the Solidarity Clinic of Kalamata.
It's August and we are taking our holidays. For 11 months, it's too much for us.
We started on 2012.
The whole number of our volunteers is about 250. About 10 doctors who are working in the clinic, and about 50 doctors who are in the city, like a wire, one specialized, when we want somebody to go to a specialized doctor, then we send it from here to his office. We work to our private offices. We just give time here. I came here about 1:30 because I was in my office. No, and we don't have an emergency section because we don't have the infrastructure to have. Here is where the doctor is and examines the patient. Only this for the general doctor. Mm-hmm. I show you what other we have. This was the nursing school. There are too many years, because the nursing school now is in the new hospital. Here there is the administration of the nursing school in the half of the building, but all the other was just not working. This is the pedicistrian for children. Here we're making the vaccines and all this. All this medicine that you see are expired. Okay, because many solidarity collectives send us medicines, but they don't check the expiring date. So when they come here, they are expired. Mm. So we have to destroy them. And it's not easy. We cannot put it in the rubbish. I don't know, his grandfather died and gave us the rest of his medicines. So we have to check how many pills there are inside. Mm-hmm. We have to put it in our computer. Because to manage all these pharmacies, you saw that it wasn't a little one, it's a big pharmacy. First, there was no money for the people to go to the doctor. Yes. And second, there were too many people, about 3 million people, who had no social security, no social insurance. Mm-hmm. So they couldn't go to the doctor, to the public doctor, and they couldn't buy their medicines. Also, there were too many refugees who, let's say, illegal, they didn't have papers and all this, so somebody had to see them. That's why we started, that was the first. Of course, our purpose, our goal, was also to show people which is the problem and how we can find solutions. Mm-hmm. And solution was only for us, with social solidarity. That means that we don't, we're not an organization of charity that, if we find poor people to give them medicines, it's not our problem. The problem is that all the guys that come here, they have to know that this is a solidarity clinic. That means that he is one of us, even if he has money or if he hasn't, it's nothing for us. Okay, the whole project is that we help each other. Mm-hmm. We are not the doctors, we're just the neighbor guy who wants to support somebody who now has no strength, but tomorrow maybe he will have and I will not. So this is solidarity, social solidarity. This is not the solution. Of course not. The solution is public health. A good public health system. We are talking with other solidarity clinics all over Greece. We are about 70. So we are making assemblies in some cities, from Saloniki, Athens, Korinthos, every 4-6 months, and talking about what's going on and exchanging experiences of what's going on to their city, to our city, or all over Greece and all of this. Talking, and we'll see. Of course, this is not the solution, and this is not the revolution, but this is a way to radicalize people about the problems that made all this situation. And that's why we are keeping on. We have three pharmacies, because the space, the rooms are not so big. So of course, all this clinic is based on solidarity working all together. So there are too many people helping us. So all this we made it by ourselves because it was an abandoned building. So it had to fix. We had to fix too many things. Mm-hmm. I mean, we have to paint it, to build something, or to put the electric lines, the water lines, the closure pipes. All these were from us. Okay. I mean, from people who helped us. The windows, all this you see here, the shelves and all this was made by us. There are always people helping us because, of course, only doctors cannot function by mm-hmm. themselves. Mm-hmm. They need help. So too many people from the city help us. Too many people of the city give us medicines. And also we have help from abroad. I mean, there are solidarity collectives in France, in England, in Germany, all over Europe that send us medicines and come and see us and all this. For example, the dental lab, the X-ray machine was bought with money that English solidarity people gave us. We occupied it because when we asked for places, they offered us some very little rooms uh-huh. and say, okay, I don't know. So we tell the mayor, you know, we are going to occupy this place. So when he saw that it was a big movement with all this, because our movement is grassroots movement, so at last he said, okay, I don't give it to you, but I will give it to the doctor association, uh-huh. and the doctor association gave it to us. Mm-hmm. Oh. If they want, we have some doctors from the hospital or from not from the hospital. No, it's not easy to find work in the hospital anyway. If you're a doctor, it's not easy. It's very complicated, and with all these crises. How you call it, austerity, they don't give us the permission to take more doctors to the hospital. All the others that are outside in the city are not public. Most of them help us, some of them don't help us. Anyway, everybody has his choice. There are many problems in the hospital. I mean, they were not paid. They reduced his their payment, many things, and they still goes on all this, okay? Mm. Because their salaries go down and down and down every month. Mm. It's for them it's very bad, yeah. But it has nothing to do with our clinic. Concepts, the law says that you have to go to some to take to go in the list, and then there is a committee. Who says who is first, who is second, who is third. And when the minister says that, okay, I want 500 doctors or 100 doctors or something like that, then we take the list and we take the first of them and so go on. But the minister don't take doctor. Mm-hmm. That's the problem. Now, as we know, the education in the universities for medical doctors, they don't have problem. Okay, they have problems when they arrive to go to the hospitals to take their specialties and such things because the hospital have no money. Mm-hmm. That's a problem. But I don't think that in the university there are problems about education and all this. We make very good doctors here in Greece. That's why Germany wants to take doctors from Greece. Mm-hmm. They are very good educated. That's mm-hmm. true. Here is our office. Coordination office for the volunteers. Okay, since we started, we have made about 15,000 or more medical actions, and we had about 5,000 or 6,000 patients all these years. Now they made a law. They made the law, which is on power till yesterday. that says that everybody can go to the hospital, even if it has social security or not. Even refugees who are not legal, but they have problem, or their women pregnant, or their little children, or all this, they can go to the hospital without free, without paying. Okay, we like this, of course. To do this, you have to put money for that. The government doesn't have the money. So, okay, it's a good law, but nobody can make it reality. He asked us to leave it, but he said, okay, let's find another building that is convenient for you, and when you find the new building, then you'll evacuate the building and give it to me. This is not the solution, and this is not the revolution, but this is a way to radicalize people about the problems that made all this situation.